we're being asked to find the limit. So whenever you're looking for a limit, a good idea is to take this number here and replace all your x's with that number. So let's see what's going on. So 8 minus 8 divided by the cube root of 8 minus 2. Now 8 minus 8 is 0, and the cube root of 8 is 2, so you get 2 minus 2, so you get 0. This is an indeterminate form, and it allows us to use L'Hopital's. So solution, we will use L'Hopital's rule. So whenever it's 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity, you can use L'Hopital's. Now L'Hopital's says that we take the derivative of the numerator and the denominator. So let's write this in a way that allows us to take the derivative easily. So let's write the cube root of x as x to the 1/3. All right, now we'll use L'Hopital's. Again, we have 0 over 0, so we're allowed to use L'Hopital's. So this is the limit as x approaches 8. And now we'll take the derivative of the numerator. So that's 1 minus 0, right? The derivative of 8 is 0, so we won't write it. In the denominator, we're just going to take this 1/3 here, and we're going to bring it downstairs. So we end up with 1/3. X to the 1/3 minus 1 is negative 2/3. Let's rewrite this in a way that eliminates the negative exponent. So this is going to be, well, this is 1 divided by 1/3. So it's 1 times 3 over 1. So you just kind of put the 3 there. So it's 3. And when you bring this upstairs, it becomes positive. X to the 2/3. All right, now we can plug in the 8. So this will be 3 times 8 to the 2/3. And let's actually clean this up. Let's clean it up carefully. So recall, if you have something like, let's see, if you have x to the m over n, the n here always goes in the little pocket. The x goes here, and you can put the m wherever you want. Let's put it outside. Or instead, if you had x to the m over n, the n here, it always goes in the little pocket. The x goes here. Last time we put the m on the outside, so now we can put it on the inside. So simplifying this, we have 3, let me write it again, times 8 to the 2/3. So we have 3, the 3 goes in the little pocket, so it's the cube root of 8. Right, 3 goes in the little pocket. And where do you put the 2? Let's put it outside because it's easier. So we get 3 times the cube root of 8 is 2, and then we still have this 2 here. So we get 3 times 4, which is equal to 12. I hope this helps someone out there.